Welcome to LEGO Tales, and today, another Avengers Age of Ultron set. And this one is, Avengers Age of Ultron, Avengers Hydra Showdown. Now, this set reminds me a lot of the one we got with Loki, Hawkeye, the last set, which came with a shield truck. Came with a shield truck, came with Hawkeye, Iron Man, and Loki. I think it was called Loki's Cosmic Cube Escape. This set reminds me a lot like that. Same price, almost same piece count. Really close. The piece count on this set is really good, by the way. 220 pieces. This set cost $19.99. Great price. Got it at Target. Ages 6 to 12. Set number 76030. Comes with 3 minifigures, one of which is exclusive. The other two are not. We'll take a look at the side of the box there. The other side. Comic book is included. And then we have the features up here. Comes with a lame super jumper. Don't like those super jumpers, as you all know. And then there's that. All right, without further ado, make sure you hit that like button right now. Subscribe if you haven't, and let's build this set. Welcome back. Here's the Hydra Showdown set. Here, Avengers Hydra Showdown set. We'll start off with the extra pieces we get. We get quite a bit of extra pieces, I think, for a $20 set. So you see here, we have a couple slow pieces. We have black, white, tan, an antenna, some trans pieces in there. And we have some good pieces in there, too. Some trans studs for the shooters. We also have an instruction manual that comes with the set. It's just normal $20 size instruction manual. And you get an advertisement for all the other Avengers Age of Ultron sets. Except for this set. You get an advertisement for all the sets except for this set. And the Hydra base smash or Hydra smash or something, whatever. Hydra Fortress Smash, that's it. So Hydra Fortress Smash, that one's not showed on here, and neither is this one. But you got a LEGO Club advertisement here, and of course the instructions. We also do get a comic book in this set. Not a big fan of these comic books. I mean, they're kind of boring. No names or anything, or no words or anything. Just scream, swish, crash, kaboom, kaboom, boom, blah, blah, blah. Never mind, you get the idea. Anyway, the first page is this set. The next says the Avengers. The next page is the Avengers Tower. The next page after that is the Avengers Tower. Then it's Iron Man versus Ultron, the $12 set. Check out my review. I already have a review out for that one. And then the Hulkbuster Rescue set. And that's 1, 2, 3 pages. And then the Avengers Quinjet City Chase is the last 1, 2, 3 pages. And on the back, you do get a checklist of all the minifigures I already have. All these Ultron guys right here, Ultron Sentry Officer and the Ultron Sentry. I don't have any Ultrons yet, but I have the Hydra Henchman. I have Iron Man Mark 45. I have Thor, Hawkeye, and the Thor, Iron Man, and Hawkeye. That's pretty much it for right now. I plan on getting the Hulkbuster set next. Anyway, let's take a look at the minifigures, starting off with the least significant, probably the Hydra henchman. Now, it's really interesting. Hydra is back now. I thought Hydra was destroyed in Captain America 2, but I guess it's not, because Hydra is back. So, this is interesting here. Very cool torso printing. Got a nice back printing as well. Very detailed. And we'll take a look at the head printing. As you see, there's nice head printing. And there is back printing as well on this minifigure. It doesn't have a specific name, or it doesn't have any weapon either. But it's just the description calls it Hydra Henchman. So there is the Hydra Henchman. Next minifigure up, and the other non-exclusive minifigure. People, this is the cheapest set to get Thor in, but he is not exclusive to this set. He has new torso printing and this new horrible cape that I don't like this cape at all. I like the harder capes, but I mean, oh well. Black arms, which is nice. He has new torso printing, which is very nice torso printing. No red on the torso. Then he has the blue legs. And he does have back printing right there. He does have a double-sided face. One side he's smiling. The other side, he's upset. So, there's Thor. Next minifigure. Last minifigure up in the only exclusive minifigure in the set. Now, this is probably the minifigure that people are going to buy this set for because this is the only set you can get Hawkeye in with that. And this Hawkeye is amazing. Better than the old Hawkeye, I think. But he has cooler torso printing, leg printing, and back printing on this minifigure. I love that red on his arms. Looks like Iron Man's arms and stuff. But the detail on that torso is just awesome. Plus, he does have a double-sided face with those glasses on. And if you notice, from 2012, the other Hawkeye we got, the hair color changed, which is really, really weird. The hair color changed also. So you see here, the face on this Hawkeye that doesn't have the glasses kind of has that same exact expression. But on this minifigure, the side that doesn't has like the same face printing. So they kind of switched the heads around a little bit. I like the torso printing on the older Hawkeye better. But anyway, we're not comparing Hawkeyes. I'll compare that in another video later on my fabulous figures. So stay tuned for that. Anyway, I love his hairpiece. I like it. I like his glasses. They're pretty cool. Comes with the bow, of course, with the arrow in it. And a black hand, tan hand. Very cool minifigure. And we do get a super jumper in this set, which there is a feature. But I don't like using the super jumper at all. So I'm not going to put the minifigure on there. But what you do is you put the minifigure right there. You push down this right here. And voila, it jumps. It jumps better when the minifigure's on there. But once again, it tears up the back of their legs and just scratches it all up. And that's horrible. Anyway, starting off with the Hydra car. For the Hydra henchmen, we'll put them on in there real quick. What you have to do to take it off is you have to take this off right here. And then you can lift this up right about here. We just put the minifigure on there. There's studs on there. So you just kind of lay them back a little bit. And then you can put him back in, put that back up, and then he can fit in his little car here. And he does have this mounted gun, which can move up and down a little bit. And then it's a stud shooter, so the way you shoot this is you just press this button, and the stud shoots. Just like that. And there is a super jumper feature here. Since I don't like using the super jumper, I'll kind of narrate it a little bit. What you do is on this side, there's this little lever right here. You pull this back, because, I mean, if that's there, then it can't fall off. If this is there, it falls right off. So you gotta move this thing down first, okay? So you move it down. Now that's just loose there, but you don't want to knock it down. You use the super jumper, and you try to knock this off, but you can't do it from this side, because then you knock it off that way, but you have to knock it off from this side. So you take the super jumper, say Thor or Hawkeye is on it or something, most likely Thor. That's what you do there. So what it is supposed to do, the minifigure makes it a little harder and flies a little better, but you push down here, jumps up, hits this, knocks the gun off. So, pretty much like that. And when you're done, you just put it back on right there. And you do have lights right here, headlights that move. You also have these things right here that move for some reason. I don't know why these are here. Just makes it look a little cooler, like a dune buggy kind of. And then you do have that Hydra sticker right there for the Hydra henchman. All right, that's it for the Hydra dune buggy. Next car up, or the next build-up is the Avengers car. So you have a Hydra Dune Buggy and an Avengers truck. Now, this is a very nice truck. I'd say it looks more like a Jeep, so that's pretty much what it is. There is no roof on it, very oddly, so you don't really have to take off anything to put them in there. You just set them in there. I think it can fit two people. Well, now, actually, it's kind of hard because you don't get that space. But, I mean, as you can see, I'm not going to put them in there now. But as you can see, they can just sit right in there. And then there is that steering wheel right there so that one person can drive and the other person can sit right there. So, very nice interior look. And in the back here, there is trunk space. If you wanted to, you could take this off and put in their hammer or the bow or anything like that. Take a prisoner or something. It does move and roll. There is an Avengers sticker right about there. As you can see, it's very nice. And more headlights, as you can see. And then you do have move mirrors right here. Mirrors that move. Inside, then there's the license plate and the trans. Now, the fighting feature on this vehicle is flick missiles. So, as you can see here, we have flick missiles that rotate 360 degrees. And then, on top of that, you can even make the missiles point up or point down. So, works pretty good for that way. You do have a moving flap right here to flick the missiles. All you have to do is flick it. So you just take that and wow, that hit all the way back there and bounced over here. We'll try it again. Oh, that time it went over the edge. Anyway, there's the vehicle. There is the Hydra Showdown set. Very cool set. Great price. $19.99, 220 pieces. Comes with three minifigures, three great minifigures, actually. One of them is exclusive. Thor is the cheapest way to get them. This is also the cheapest way to get the Hydra henchmen. But anyway, great set. Out of 10, I'm going to give it a 10 because this set rocks. The minifigures are great. The build is great. The play features are great. The price per piece count is great. So, rocking set. All the Avengers sets are really rocking. So, can't wait to get my next one. Tell me what you guys think of this set. Like, subscribe, tell me what you think of the set down in the comment section below. And I'll see you next time here on LEGO Tales TV.